Israel is one of the most famous countries in the world because it is regarded as the holy land by Christians. This means that it receives a huge number of tourists who visit to experience the life and journey of Christ. Therefore, people going to visit the country need to be aware of the laws put in place so that they do not end up paying a fine or getting arrested. Some of the laws seem to make no sense, but they have to abide by them nonetheless. Furthermore, some of these laws are not written in the constitution but are frowned upon while in the country. This video will delve into strange laws someone should be aware of in Israel so that they are not shocked when they are in the country. One should not bring their bear to the beach. Israel bans people who have bears as pets, not allowed bringing them to the beach. Pet owners need to find another place that is not the beach to have some quality time with their bear. This law is strange in that why would someone have a bear as a pet? The rationale for this law is attributed that the bear will scare the other beachgoers and cause a disruption. Do not speak about politics. Visitors going to Israel need to know that political talk in the public is prohibited. This is because when people talk about politics, it always gets heated due to the country's history and current conflicts. This means that everyone stays with their opinion and the case is not similar to the one their partner has. One should not keep walking after they have heard the Memorial Day siren. In Israel, there are 2 days in the year when the soldiers of the military stand for 1 minute to commemorate the fallen soldiers from the Holocaust. Therefore, when the siren is heard, then everyone is required to stand still and pay their respects. Do not ask for a cheeseburger in a kosher restaurant. When in a restaurant that sells kosher food, one should not order a cheeseburger. Kosher restaurants abide by the Jewish dietary rules, which restrict pork and shellfish in their diet. Therefore, the restaurants will not serve burgers that contain bacon and cheese. When one is visiting the country, they should look for non-kosher restaurants if they want food that is restricted by the Jewish laws. A person is not allowed to touch an Orthodox person of the opposite sex. Rules set by the Orthodox Jews do not allow physical contact with the opposite genders unless it is a close member of the family, like a parent, spouse, child, or sibling. Not all Jews have issues with this law, but Orthodox Jews usually keep their distance from members of the opposite sex. Therefore, while touring the Holy Land and someone moves seats or goes further away from you to avoid accidental touches, then one should not be offended as their laws restrict physical touch with the opposite gender. Army service is a must in Israel. When you see a large number of soldiers on the streets, one should not be alarmed because Israel has compulsory military service that youths have to join when they turn 18. This means that there will be many soldiers on the streets as all the 18-year-olds have joined the Israeli Defense Force. The weapons they carry are for defense purposes only. Driving on Yom Kippur is not allowed. Yom Kippur is the Day of Atonement in Hebrew, which is considered to be one of the holiest days in the Jewish religion. The event features a 25-hour fast meant to show remorse for the sins one has committed. During this time, driving cars is not allowed and the streets are empty. This rule can be attributed to wanting silence to meditate on one's sin. Therefore, when a tourist visits the country during this time, they should be aware of the rule. Declawing your cat can land you in jail. The procedure is actually known as an onychectomy, and it entails more than just removing the nail. In most cases, the entire toe joint, including the bone, is severed, which is equivalent to having your fingertips cut off around the third knuckle. Because cats rely on this part of their paw while walking, Israel believes the move will protect cats' ability to walk normally and defend themselves, as well as prevent medical complications that affect up to 20% of cats after declawing. Always leave a tip. Most Israeli waiters live on tips instead of actual salaries. This means that tipping is common in this part of the world, and it is also quite high because people tip about 15% of the meal. The concept of tipping is very common that the staff would consider it rude when one does not leave a tip. Therefore, this is another unwritten rule that people who want to visit the country should keep in mind so that they can enjoy their experience in Israel. It is illegal to rear a pig on Israeli soil. A law was enacted in 1962 that banned raising pigs on Israeli soil and also slaughtering them so that they can be consumed by humans. Thus, the law is strange in that the sale of pork is allowed in the country but rearing them is not. However, there are a small number of pig farms that are mostly managed by Russian immigrants. Citizens of the country tried to look for a loophole where they would raise the pigs on a concrete slab instead of the bare ground, which is also funny. Therefore, if one is planning to relocate to Israel, they should know that raising pigs on Israeli soil is a no. Public display of affection is not allowed. Public shows of affection, including kissing, may be discouraged or met with disapproval in some religious or conservative parts of Israel. These cultural standards are a result of traditional values and beliefs that place a strong emphasis on humility and discretion in love interactions. Although it is not a nationwide norm, it is crucial to be aware of regional differences in local customs and sensitivities. It is advised to use caution and to be aware of the cultural context when making displays of affection in public places if you find yourself in one of these places. You cannot collect rainwater without a permit. Without a permit, it is illegal to collect rainwater from your own roof in Israel. In a country that often experiences water shortages and uses a variety of measures to secure water supply, this law aims to manage and maintain water resources. Authorities can monitor and regulate water use, guaranteeing a just distribution and sustainable management of this priceless resource by issuing licenses for rainwater collection. Cigarette packaging is required to display a graphic warning image. In Israel, graphic images and language warning of the dangers of smoking cigarettes must be displayed on the packaging. The purpose of this law is to promote public health and increase awareness of the negative effects of smoking. The government wants to discourage smoking and promote people to make wise decisions regarding their health. To that end, they have placed prominent visual warnings and educational statements on cigarette packs. Excessive noise during specific hours of the night is not allowed. It is illegal in Israel to make excessive noise at specified times of the night. This law is in place to make sure that residents can rest peacefully and quietly during the allotted time for doing so. By not allowing excessive noise during specific hours, such as late at night or early in the morning, the law seeks to avoid interruptions that can bother people, disrupt their ability to sleep, or otherwise have a detrimental effect on their well-being. The whole idea is to not have noise pollution, which can be strange when certain people would want a wild night out. Citizens must walk around with their legal documents throughout. Passports and other forms of identification are required by law to be carried by Israeli citizens at all times. This requirement was put in place to make sure that people could easily prove their identification and legal status when needed, allowing law enforcement officers to quickly confirm a person's identity and take necessary action when necessary is seen as a safety measure. But what happens when you forget? It's illegal to drive a car with dirty license plates. Israel has a law that makes it illegal to drive with dirty or hard-to-read license plates. The main reason for this law is to help keep people safe on the roads and make it easier for the police to do their jobs. If a license plate is very dirty and hard to read, it can be difficult for the police to identify the vehicle, especially if it is involved in a crime or accident. The police actively enforce this law, and drivers can get fined or even have their cars taken away if their license plates are too dirty. The government in Israel believes this law is important because it helps them enforce other traffic laws and encourages drivers to take care of their vehicles. There are some exceptions, like if the weather makes the plates hard to read, but in general, all drivers in Israel must keep their license plates clean and easy to read. Residents must obtain a permit to hold a garage sale. In Israel, residents are not allowed to just have a garage sale whenever they want. Instead, they have to get a special permit from the government first before they can hold a garage sale. The reason for this law is that the government wants to keep track of and regulate these kinds of small, temporary sales. They likely want to make sure things are being sold legally and safely. If an Israeli tries to have a garage sale without getting the required permit first, they could get in trouble with the authorities. There may be fines or other penalties for not following this law. The permit process is probably there to give the government some control and oversight over these kinds of sales. Even though it's just a small garage sale, the government still wants residents to get permission before holding one. It's illegal for a woman to wear a dress that is deemed too short in public. In Israel, there is a law that says women are not allowed to wear dresses or skirts that are considered too short when they are out in public. The government has decided that there are certain lengths of dresses or skirts that are not appropriate for women to wear when they are in public places. If a woman's dress or skirt is deemed to be too short, she can get in trouble for it. The reason for this law is that the government wants to control how women dress and what they can wear out in public. They believe there are certain standards of modesty that women should follow, and short dresses or skirts are seen as going against those standards. If a woman is caught wearing a dress or skirt that is too short, according to the authorities, she could face fines or other punishments. The police or other officials may even tell her that she needs to change her clothing before she can continue being in public. This law is quite unusual and controversial, as it restricts the freedom of women to wear what they want. But in Israel, the government has decided that they have the right to decide how short is too short for a woman's dress or skirt in public places. It is illegal to pick up hitchhikers in Israel. The reason for this law is that the government believes it can be dangerous for drivers to stop and let strangers into their cars. They want to try to prevent any potential crimes or safety issues that could happen. So if a driver sees someone trying to hitchhike and stops to give them a ride, the driver could get in trouble with the law. There may be fines or other penalties for picking up hitchhikers. The police in Israel enforce this law, and they will pull over drivers they see picking up hitchhikers. The drivers could face legal consequences, even though they were just trying to be helpful by giving someone a ride. This law is a bit unusual, As in many other places, picking up hitchhikers is generally allowed. Using a mobile phone while driving is illegal, even with a hands-free device. The government has banned this practice because they believe it can be dangerous for drivers to be distracted by their phones while driving. They want to minimize any potential distractions that could lead to accidents or unsafe driving. So if an Israeli driver is caught talking on their phone, whether it's handheld or hands-free, they can get in trouble with the law. There may be fines or other penalties imposed on them for violating this rule. The police actively enforce this law and will pull over drivers they see using their phones. The authorities want to make sure everyone on the road stays focused and safe.